welcome to the latest edition of What's New at Spellbinders. I'm Nicole, and I am very happy to be sharing with you the latest collection from Becca Feakin, Amazing Paper Grace, and this is called Elegant Twist. Now, this is a 6Q line. There are 5 dies, and there's one add-on glimmer that just works perfectly with all these dies. So let's take a look. Elegant Twist is the name, and I suspect you can see why. Now, she has this in the 4 basic shapes, so I'm going to show you the 4 shapes. We'll start with rectangles, and there are 7 dies. Now, I want you to know that all of these are designed for A2 size card fronts. So this rectangle is about 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, it's just shy. So it fits perfectly on an A2 size card, and you'll see that in just a second. So there are 7 dies in this collection. Actually, there's 7 dies, I'm sorry, in this set. There's 7 in each of the basic shapes. And there's tons of versatility here because you can use the outer frame, the inner frame, you can just use the inner piece, and we have them in various sizes. So let me show you how that comes to life on a card. So here's one, for example, where we have only used this to cut the outside frame. So for this one, we have used, I'll show you here, we've used these 2 dies and then left the inside closed and then used some beautiful printed paper. And there you have it. Very simple card, but these dies are so elegant. It just really elevates your creation. Now I'll show you a different one that's used in a slightly different way. This one then created a frame. So to do this guy, we would simply add in, it's a smaller size, so I'll show you that. So we would have the outer frame, we would have the beautiful twist piece, and then we would have the inner frame, and that's what would be used to cut this piece out. So there you go. Now you're also seeing some glimmer action there, and I am going to show you that skew at the end, but this is a little foreshadowing for what's coming there. And then this card, of course, was finished with some of Becca's beautiful cinch and go flowers. So that is the rectangle. Let's take a look at the other shapes. So our next shape in the line is an oval. Again, perfectly sized for an A2 size card front. 7 dies, just like we had with the rectangles. And let me show you this example. Now this shows, again, the versatility of those dies, using it to cut the outer piece, leaving the inner full, and then using the middle size there to cut a frame. Finished with some of Becca's cinch and go flowers and one of her beautiful glimmer sentiments. And you have an elegant card to say thanks. Now the other shapes follow very much the same suit. We have the circle, again, 7 dies, same kind of concept here. I'll show you a card made with the circle. Look at this beauty. Very simple, yet stunning and elegant. Just some beautiful gold foiled paper. Cut out that circle, the elegant twist circle in the metallic gold. And again, finished with the cinch and go flower. Beautiful. And finally, in the basic shapes category here, we have the square. So again, 7 dies, same kind of concept. And here is a sample with that. So again, cutting these out of the metallic or the mirror gold just really takes it to another level. Now you may be seeing this little piece here, and I will show you that skew up next. That is the Splendid Trilliant die. So this one has a lot of versatility, a lot of options, and I'm going to take you through each of those pieces. So we have an outside cut line here, an inner piece, and then this cute little label that we've used on tons of different projects. It's a great little size and shape. And then we have this little corner piece, and I'll show you the corner piece specifically because there's so many different ways you can use it. So you have your kind of outside frame here of a corner, but you also have this inlay. So on the card I just showed you, this one here, you can see that we used just the inlay there and created this cute little cutout. But if you want to use the actual full corner piece, this is what you get. So if you cut out this guy, you're going to get just like this, and then you can fold it and wrap it around and create adorable little corners for your cards. And then if you add the little inlay, then you get an adorned corner, same kind of thing. And this would be really cute to add on to, again, any of your cards. Now we use it in a different way. I showed you on the square card, but I'll show you on this one as well, where we just use the inlay. So you can see here in the background, we just used this piece to cut out those 4 corners, and then we layered it with this beautiful Splendid Trilliant cutout. And then you also can see peeking in there is one of the Elegant Twist ovals, the smallest size. Isn't that stunning? Just beautiful. And again, using the die in a little different way, here we have this guy. So this one used the kind of base Splendent Trilliant piece with that perfectly shaped, perfectly sized little badge in the middle, and then cut out two extra in the silver and kind of offset them to create this beautiful focal for the bow and the sentiment. Now, speaking of the sentiment, I will bring in the last SKU in the collection, which is a glimmer set. So let's take a look at that glimmer set now. So this is GLP 176. There are 9 plates in this set, and it's, again, incredibly versatile. So what you have in the set, I'll kind of catch some of the light so you can see, just to kind of show you how these would come to life when we glimmer them. A little hard with the studio lights, but you see the sentiments there. And then you also get the actual Elegant Twist kind of design in both directions, so to speak. So you can use it multiple ways, kind of like we did on that first card, which I'll bring in here in a minute. But there's something else that I'd like to show about these plates. So here are the plates. And you'll always be able to tell the difference between a glimmer and a die because they are a little thicker and they don't have those sharp edges. So you can feel that by, by rubbing your finger over it. And one thing that we've started to do on a lot of our glimmer sentiments is create these little grooves, these little notches. So it's kind of hard to see, but this one says, "I'm here for you always," which is a beautiful sentiment. But if you want to add the extra "I care" and you want to glimmer that together, you would just put that on your platform and kind of align those little notches together, and then you have perfectly placed sentiment. And the same thing holds here for "I will never forget your kindness." So we made that into 2 rows so that it would fit better on the front of an A2 size card. So again, tons of versatility here with these glimmer sentiments. These were designed by Becca, and they're just really sweet, very kind sentiments. And just to tell someone you care. So I'm bringing in this card again to show you how these guys glimmer. So again, we have them in both directions, so you can see how that was used there. And then "You are on my mind," just simple and kind, something to send to a friend. So there you have it, the latest collection from Becca Feakin, Elegant Twist. Again, 5 dies and that 1 glimmer. For information about this collection or any of our collections, you can visit our website at spellbinderspaperarts.com.